Major security breach that took place in the Mumbai airport after a man entered the tarmac area and literally obstructed a Spicejet aircraft which was about to take off. Now, this aircraft was about to take off from Mumbai to Bengaluru when the pilots noticed a man, in fact, just sauntering around in the tarmac while the aircraft was taxiing. According to DGCA, around 1:30 p.m., this man from Sion had jumped across the wall from the southern side of the runway 27, crossed the perimeter intrusion identification system. That is where he was spotted. He was later picked up from the runway and arrested by CISF. Pilots of the Spicejet aircraft showed tremendous presence of mind to halt operations of the aircraft. In fact, they noticed this person on the tarmac just in time. CISF has now ordered an inquiry into this incident. Santhia Gora joining us live. Santhia, once again, the pilots, of course, have shown presence of mind. But the fact of the matter is it so simple for anyone to trespass into the runway? Why did this go unnoticed?
Yes, absolutely, Afrida. It was not just roaming. It looked like he had an entire ball there on the runway. He actually was inspecting Spicejet plane which was there for taxiing. And if we talk about the incident that took place at 1:27 yesterday afternoon, actually he entered from the southern part of the airport, southern wall of the airport. And if we talk about this man, as of now he's said to be mentally challenged, and he is one of the slum dwellers out of those 80,000 slum dwellers who live nearby Mumbai airport. So first of all, this thing in itself is questionable, that how exactly 80,000 slum dwellers are residing so close to an airport like Mumbai airport. So now if we talk about this history, in 2007 Mumbai airport authorities actually gave the job of rehabilitating these slum dwellers to Maharashtra state's housing department, but till date also, after 12 years also, those slum dwellers are still there. In fact, in 2018 one CAG report came out, and that CAG report actually held the state government's housing department and a slum rehabilitation authority responsible for not being able to relocate these 80,000 people. And the CAG report clearly mentioned that how this is a serious threat to Mumbai airport and the safety and security. Despite that, state government is not doing anything. The departments of state government were pulled up in that CAG report. In fact, CAG report also said that how, if we talk about the reasons which SRA is giving for not being able to relocate these people, is first that how they are actually unable to make a list of the eligible tenants who have to be relocated, and those who are not eligible for a relocation. That's one hurdle SRA is giving. And another one is that how they are, whenever they try and demolish the slum or try and relocate them, they face protest and objection from the slum dwellers, so they are unable to do it. Apart from that, if we talk about slum dwellers, they have always said that how they don't have a proper alternative to move to go to, that's why they are not ready to move. So mm-hmm. These are the things. In fact, CAG report also again and again mentioned that how it is actually also a result of no coordination between the different departments of state government, which is Housing Department of Maharashtra State Government and Slum Rehabilitation Authority of Maharashtra Government, resulting into these 80,000 slum dwellers still being there right next to the airport. Yes. Where anyone can actually enter Mumbai airport.
Yes, the runway being that accessible to people, and like you said, there's slum dwellers around this area. Somebody like this person did can always cross over. So one has to look at the larger issue here, as Santhia is pointing out for us. There's a bigger problem behind this. Thanks for giving us a clear picture, Santhia.